Hey guys, it's Crystal. How are you doing? I hope that you are having a beautiful day wherever you are on the planet today. Just a beautiful day and a beautiful life. I wanted to get online and just share with you what's up with me because it's been about a week and a half since I've posted. I like to post once or twice, maybe three times a week if I can. And it's just been hard to do that based on some of the things that I'm going through. And so I wanted to share what's going on in my life right now. So this is not a targeted spiritual teaching, metaphysical immersion. This is just, here's what's up with me. Here's what's going on, just so that you guys can know. And also so that we can connect. I just want to be able to share parts of myself with you as opposed to just, you know, always teaching or stuff like that. I'm a person. I go through stuff and I'm presently going through something. Before I do that, though, I wanted to put out a couple of messages. First being, I am looking for a website designer. My website is crystalannecompton.com. Don't forget the E in Ann, crystalannecompton.com. And it's pretty basic. And I've been intending to redesign it. And I've talked to a couple of designers, but like I haven't found the right fit yet. And I'm looking for somebody who kind of understands my vision, understands what it is that I'm talking about, gets a sense of who it is that I am as a person, and who can create a website in alignment with that. So if you are a website designer and if you think, that might be interesting, or if you know a website designer who might be up for it and who's good and who can provide samples, I'd like to check out your sites and see the kind of work that you've done. Please write me at crystal@crystalannecompton.com. Don't forget the E. crystal@crystalannecompton.com. Again, provide me some samples. I'd love that. And if I feel like we are in alignment, I will go ahead and reach out to you and we can see what we can do. I'm excited about it. The second thing I wanted to mention is that at the end of this summer, I am going to be hosting and facilitating and teaching at and channeling at the 2019 Bliss Retreat. This is our third annual retreat. It takes place from August 29th to September 2, so 4 nights and 5 days in beautiful Loveland, Colorado. And when I tell you it's going to be a beautiful time, I truly mean it. We have spiritual workshops, sacred ceremonies, nightly services where I facilitate, teach, channel, or just allow spirit to do whatever spirit wants to do through me. And it's an immersive, kind of saturating experience. It's just, we're in the spirit of spirit. We are in that high vibration and we are there with one another. I have met some of the most beautiful people I've ever known in my life at the Bliss Retreat. And it is one of the only opportunities I personally have to meet people in my community or people who are connected to me face to face. Normally, I do everything online. So it's just a really great opportunity to have a weekend full of bliss, full of fellowship, and full of high vibration. And if you're interested in checking it out, learning more about it, go to theblissretreat.org. I talk about the speakers, I talk about the workshops, I talk about everything, and you can register right there. I will say, though, that I have to update theblissretreat.org because we've just added a workshop where we are going to be learning chakra dance, how to move energy through the chakras, and also that's going to segue into a beautiful blissed out gong bath and sound healing session. I love those. I don't know if you've ever been to a gong bath or just allowed the energy of the gong or crystal bowls to wash over you and adjust you and recalibrate you. It's powerful. So we're going to be doing that too. And I'm super excited. Theblissretreat.org. There are some spaces available. We already have a really good crew signed up. So you are about to meet some wonderful, beautiful people. And the thing about my communities, I do have to say, is that I insist upon coming from, to the best of our ability, coming from a place of love and coming from a heart-oriented position, non-judgmental, compassionate, like giving everybody that we encounter the benefit of the doubt and assuming of them the very best about them in any interaction. That's just, I feel, the way that we should be moving in this world. We should be blessing one another. And so in our communities, even here on this page, that's kind of the standard. And certainly at the Bliss Retreat, when we're all there in real life, face to face, interacting, sitting there, eating together, that's just what it is. We come from a place of compassion. And if you want to meet spiritually connected people who are coming from the heart, who are heart-centered and who can hold space and support and who you can support, there's no better place than the blissretreat.org. All right. Okay. So I got that out. I'm very excited to go to the Bliss Retreat, as perhaps you can tell. Now moving on to what's going on with me. Well, as you can tell, I'm looking a little bit run down, a little bit, maybe a lot of bit run down. My energy is a little off. And also, my communication is a little off. I found myself in the last couple of weeks just having a difficult time expressing myself. I don't know if you are a singer or if you know about singing, but there's kind of the difference between singing from your diaphragm or like your power position and singing from what's called headspace, which is sort of a tinny kind of shallow voice. It's like I've been living in a headspace. I've just been living in a real shallow, sort of not super strong or pono solid space for the last 2 weeks. And it's because I am going through a wellness and health journey. I undertook this journey, or I began this journey, at the end of April. And I'm doing this with the help of a really talented, almost magical, savant level acupuncturist and Chinese herbalist. And every week I go for acupuncture, and it's hard. When I tell you that my expectations versus the reality of acupuncture were so wildly disparate, I mean, I'm not understating that. I thought acupuncture was like, oh, let's just, no problem, you won't even feel the needles. Well, that's not the acupuncture that I'm doing. I feel those needles, they're going through my fascia. I feel those needles, they are hitting nerves. I feel those needles, and it's hard. And it's like a meditation every week just to kind of get through the treatments, because I'm just averse. I'm becoming averse to it, but I'm doing it anyway. And that's because for a while now, I have just had the sense that due to choices, lifestyle choices and decisions and things that I've done and age and all that, due to all of that, I was predisposing myself to upcoming imbalance and potentially even illness. And I wanted to do what I could right now when I'm strong, do what I could right now when I'm healthy for the most part, and bring that into alignment, because the work that I'm doing, especially in the future, the work that I'm doing requires a physical instrument that can hold the space of that, that can hold the energy of that. And when you're working with divine energy, you're working with the strongest, most powerful energy available in all of creation. So I have to have a physical instrument that can do this work. And I knew that that was starting to get compromised. And in particular, I presented my symptoms when I started this particular journey. And I'm like, my digestion is off. It's been off for 22 years since I got sick a long time ago. I was in a coma. It was a whole thing. And I've got 3 autoimmune disorders. I have sciatica, I've got insomnia. I'm just like energetically all over the place. And it all starts with my gut. So he put me on a pretty, well, I want to say aggressive for me, but not for him. He's not a crowbar kind of a doctor. He's just like, let's just see what the symptoms are and let's just start addressing them. Let's start coaxing the systems back online. But what happens is when your systems come back online after periods of dormancy, because maybe you've been in periods of imbalance or illness, and so certain things, your kidneys aren't functioning the way they should, or your neurology isn't functioning the way that it should. When these systems start to come back online, the gunk and muck and energy that they were holding on to in their dormancy is released. And it's released as typically inflammation, but it's released into the system and shows up as health crises or as symptoms. And it can be anything. Inflam can show up anywhere. And so for the last 6 weeks, what is today? 5-6 weeks, I've just been like Neo. I've just been like trying to deal with my symptoms. And they started off real grounded and physical. Like I woke up one day and I had this terrible, terrible pain in my foot. And it was so anomalous and it was so terrible that I ended up going to the ER. I knew intuitively this is the acupuncture. This is stuff moving around. This is systems coming back online. But because I've got a weird medical history with clots and stuff, I'm like, let me just go and make sure I'm not like, I don't have a clot in my foot or something, which is possible. Go to the ER, x-rays, tests, nothing is wrong with me. So I ended up calling it my ghost foot. I just had a weird ghost foot, but the very next day it was completely resolved. And I don't know what that was about. I've also had skin rashes. I've had weird energetic fluctuations. And of course, this issue with my neurology, which is affecting the way I speak, and it's affecting the way I even access words. I think the term is aphasia. I don't have full-blown aphasia. Aphasia is where you reach for a word that you know, but you can't get there. It's almost like you can get to the filing cabinet, but you can't get to the file, which is where the word is. So I know that there's a word that I want to say, but I can't get there, so I use a replacement word. And it's just not my typical neurology. I'm pretty fast, and I'm a speaker by trade. So it's been weird, man. And I haven't wanted to make videos because I feel off. I feel like I'm headspace. I feel like I am out of my body by a third to a half. Like, I feel like I'm astral. My dreams are weird, man. I'm like, when I lie down, I'm slipping into weird hypnagogic trance states, and I'm like perceiving all this information, which is cool because that is representative of my systems coming back online. And let me just tell you a story because it was really funny. So this was not this week, but last week while I'm being tortured on the table. Lord Jesus. Being tortured on the table. And he's like needling my head, man. Like just all these needles in my head. And so I had heard about acupuncture for chakras and spiritual activation. And so I asked him, I'm like, is there acupuncture treatments for chakras or for ascension or for shift? And he told me, your question is out of order. Like Pai Mei. Your question is out of order. You cannot poop. I loved it. Your question is out of order. You cannot even poop. Let's deal with you pooping. Let's deal with you just having a normal functioning body. Then we can talk about the subtle energy of the throat chakra, crown chakra, third eye chakra. We can talk about different spiritual things. But until you get the foundation right, your question is out of order. And I loved that. First of all, there's not a lot of people that talk to me like that. Your question is out of order, Crystalline Compton. I'm like, oh, damn. Okay. My bad. So he set me right. And then he showed me like what the problem was. And I've mentioned in a couple of videos, haven't I? I've said that last year, my guides were really quiet. And in fact, it was all very quiet. There was the work, there was the energy, there was the practice, but the input was quiet, and it was more subtle than I'm normally used to, because normally there's a lot of evidences and there's a lot of dynamism in what it is that I do and how I experience life. And I thought it was because, and it could be because I needed the silence and the space to figure out like how to make the right choices for myself. We don't always need spirit to tell us what we know that we need to do. Sometimes our spirit guides just sit back. Sometimes God just sits back and says, you know this, you got this, how about do this, right? And so I just looked at 2018 as a whole lot of that, like, okay, you're pretty quiet and I'm getting upset about that, but like, I got this and I'm going to have to navigate this on my own. However, I'm also coming to realize that a lot of this is because of the physical imbalance in my body. Your question is out of order. You cannot even poop. As above, so below. We've heard that a lot, right? Well, the opposite is also true. As below, so above. And we can say below here, in this example, is our physical body. And if in your physical body, you are drastically out of alignment, like you can't function normally, you cannot go to the bathroom like normal people do, you can't walk like normal people do because you got this crazy sciatica issue that you never had before, you have a ghost foot, and now you're hobbling around or you're in a wheelchair. Like, you have to get these issues right. And you also have to honor the physical body in such a way so as to be of the mind that you want to bless it and partner with the physical body. And I don't even like calling it because it's me. It's me in expression. My physical body is me in expression. And if there's dysfunction in the expression of me, the soul, within the physical body, well, then that dysfunction needs to be brought into alignment, which is why I sought out this particular acupuncturist and Chinese herbalist, because I knew he was the kind of guy who would tell me, your question is out of order. Like, let's get real here, lady. Okay? And that's what I've needed to hear. And so I'm working on my physical body. And some of my problem is, as an entrepreneur, as a business person, I work a lot. And sometimes when we have our own business, we lose sight of why we're doing the work. And I'm not saying I've done that, because again, I have a spiritual practice and I truly love God, and I like to dwell in that. But if the work is so much, it's like it becomes harder to create the time and the space to make sure you're doing the things that keep you in that connection. And so for me, it's about returning to the foundation of it. It's about returning to the physical body. And even though I have a lot of projects and I'm excited about it, I'm excited about that bliss retreat and I'm going to be there, it's going to be awesome, I have to focus on my physical instrument. In fact, Spirit told me, as my systems are coming back online, right? Spirit told me 2019 is just about that. Can you dig it? Can you handle that? Like, can you handle like not creating new projects? Can you handle not entering into new innovative, creative ideas and things and experiences? Can you handle hanging out in your bed today and just resting? Can you handle just integrating the nutrition or allowing yourself to become super disciplined in how you're eating, how you're drinking, and what you're doing? Can you commit to that? As above, so below. As below, so above. Your question is out of order. You cannot even poop. Can we just get you there? And that question caused me to wobble, man. I was like, whoa, I don't know. Like, I got a lot of people I feel responsible to. There's a lot of people in my program. Like, there's a lot of stuff going on. And there's these dreams and these visions that I have for myself moving forward. Like, how am I going to get there if I don't start? And I've got to take action steps. Spirit's like, can you handle? Just stop. Take care of yourself. Your question's out of order. You cannot even poop. So in the last few weeks, there has been a great capitulation in that I have said, yes, I can handle 2019. I can handle restructuring and I can handle getting the physical body into alignment. That is my greatest work. If I can't do that, I'm not going to be able to get to all of the other things that Spirit has shown me. I will not be able to create, be inspired, be motivated, and I can also not motivate anybody else or help anybody else to be creative and inspirational if I cannot get to the foundation and start to put the structure back in place. So for the last 6 weeks, that's what I've been doing. I've been putting myself on the table, everybody. I've been schlepping myself over there. Lord. Yesterday I was on the table and he hit these 2 points in my wrist. He went to this wrist and it was not cool. I was not happy about it. I was like, oh Lord, that hurt. And he's like, okay, good. I'm sorry. But it's like, we need to like loosen the pressure here. Then he went to the same side over here and he did it and it was uncomfortable, but it didn't hurt as much. And me never can keep the mouth shut. I said, okay, cool. That one didn't hurt as much. And he said, oh, thanks for telling me that. And he stuck it in deeper because he needed to get a nerve response and it jangled my whole hand up my thumb. I was like, oh, when I tell you that laying on that table is a demonstration to myself that I have the ability to commit myself and stay committed, that's what that's doing. Like, this sucks, but I'm going to do it anyway. That's been my work. He said I have to give it at least 8 weeks. I'm on the sixth week, but it could be as much as 12 weeks of every week, changing the herbals, doing the acu, doing the deep work, doing the shifting, systems coming back online. Crystal can't speak a full sentence. Crystal's in her head. Crystal's astral. Crystal's dancing in the fourth dimension. It's going to take some time for me to feel Pono again or solid. And so I wanted you guys to know that. So if I'm a little bit not as present, or if my presentation when I am online is a little wobbly, that's why. I have to do this in order to be the very best that I can be in my life, in my health, in my marriage, to my child, to my animals, to my followers, to my community, but most of all, to Spirit. I have to be the very best that I can be. I want to be here for a long time. I really do. I want to be here for a long time. And I am in such a privileged position to be able to be of service to such a fantastic community of people truly seeking to spiritually connect. And you and I have that in common. I'm doing this so that I can bless the expression of my soul as it's showing up in this life. and also to bless you guys as well. So I hope you understand. I hope you can forgive. Okay. All nuts. I hope you understand. It's not going to be long. It's going to be a couple, 2 to 4 weeks before I'm feeling a lot better. And then you will see me a lot more. Until then, I got nothing but love for you. I hope you have love for me. And I will see you in the next video. Bye, guys. Join me this year at the 2019 Bliss Retreat in beautiful Loveland, Colorado. The Bliss Retreat is a 4-night, 5-day blissed out extravaganza where there will be sacred ceremonies, spiritual workshops, and nightly services with me, Crystal Ann Compton. Go to theblissretreat.org to learn more. I hope to see you there.